youth who demonstrates hope, inspiration, and the desire and taking part of making the world a better place. And the person who's receiving the Hope Award this year is Sarah Decker. Sarah Decker was actually one of Jana's very close friends. And Sarah is not a sudden cardiac arrest activist. She chose a different path. And what she has shared with us has been really touching. And she was inspired by Janet, who was a firm believer in treating people fairly and kindly and was not a participant in being mean to other students and her peers. Sarah shared with me that sometimes when she was younger, she didn't always take that path. And when Jana passed, she was extremely moved, and it really altered her future in ways that you really can't imagine. Sarah chose to become an upstander, to go against anti-bullying, to stop bullying, and to really create a respect that exists among students and their peers, and to embrace each other's differences. And it's okay if you're not in a certain clique, and it's okay if you don't look a certain way or talk a certain way, or you're not the right color or anything like that. So Sarah has been active for probably the last, at least 5 years in being an upstander and getting others to be an upstander. If you look upstander up in the Webster's Dictionary, you won't find it there because it isn't considered a word. Sarah is actively working on getting it added to the dictionary, and she has a petition, which we'll post a link to our Facebook page so that you guys can all go out there and click on this link and help her get a lot of votes to get it added. But if you go in Urban Dictionary and you look it up, you'll see that it says it's someone who embraces differences in others. It's someone who allows others to have their own beliefs. And Sarah really embodies that and is doing all that she can to make the world a better place. So Sarah is away at college and her dad is here. We're gonna hand him the award, but Sarah sent a very short 2-minute video and we would like to share it with you at this time. We're very proud of Sarah and we're very proud that she is sharing a part of Jana that was really about kindness and acceptance of others. So Mike Decker, if you could come up and we'll hand you the award and then we'll show Sarah's video.
I met Janet in the first grade, and on Mrs. Bagan's color box carpet, we became best friends. I learned many things from Janet. I learned how to make Coca-Cola Slurpees out of snow, how to play Truth and Dare and freeze tag, but the most important thing that I learned from Janet was how to be an upstander. Janet always did what was right, no matter who was watching or who she was with. Janet was not just a friend to me, but to everyone, and her heart was always open. An upstander sees wrong and acts, standing up for injustice and helping those in need. Our history has seen many upstanders, the men and women who helped hide European Jews during the Holocaust, the subway Samaritan who saved a man having a seizure from an incoming train. But to me, Janet was my hero and my upstander, and from her, I learned how to recognize when things are wrong and how to have the courage and the compassion to make them right. Today, I feel Janet with me every day. Janet has changed my life. The importance of Janet's story and the way she lived her life have been encapsulated in time through the Janet Fund and the truly remarkable accomplishments of Mr. and Mrs. Zilinski. I would like to take this time to thank the Zilinskis. You are an inspiration and a force of true love and compassion. You are both remarkable upstanders. I cannot describe the pride and honor I feel for being presented the Hope Award. Janet's Fund represents a hope for a better, safer future for our children. To me personally, Janet herself represents hope. Hope that we can all love one another as much as Janet loved everyone in her life. Hope that we can see wrong and act instead of remaining silent. Hope that we can change our world through kindness and compassion. Hope that we can all act as upstanders, and hope that we can all lead our lives as Janet did. Thank you.
Every day is so wonderful.
How about another round of applause for Jim and Karen and Sarah and everybody else who worked so hard putting this night together. I'll just share with you one thing. Jim and I spoke this week, and by the way, Mark